The title of my talk, scheduled in the program, is rather ugly. This was somehow I submitted the abstract and the talk and the title several months ago. The actual title is a little bit sounds a little bit better. So a dynamic quantum time crystal, new state of matter, and maybe this is a new candidate for pseudo-gap state and coup rates, but what I will speak of is completely more general, and I will show that this state quantum time crystal, thermodynamics quantum state time crystal is possible. So what is time crystal actually, what I want to speak of? The space crystal, everybody understands what is that. It is determined, for example, by a long-range order. You take a position of an atom or electron here and there, and it is just periodic function. So what is this time or space-time crystal? This can be said of that it is a periodic oscillation in time of physical quantities that can be observed experimentally. That's what I give this somehow notion now. And I emphasize that I want to speak of thermodynamically stable state, not something like out of equilibrium. So why do I say that this is somehow a new state? We know that there are thermodynamic states, phase transitions. Of course, one can start with Landau theory of phase transitions, and then all these fluctuations. Then we understand that also topological phase transitions exist, like Brzezinski-Kosterlitz-Stawlitz transition. There are systems out of equilibrium with a large relaxation time, but this is not a stable thermodynamical state. They evolve in time. So the list is long. What is somehow the major feature of all these transitions? The point is that we speak of these transitions, how this state changes. They are all time independent. So if you have thermodynamically stable state, it is time independent, and other parameters may have a spatial dependence, but otherwise they are constant. Sometimes it is very difficult to observe the states experimentally. So the last the good example is that the first talk of this conference, observation of Larkin, Ovchinnikov, full deferral superconductivity state. So it was proposed in middle of 60s and observed only now. But nevertheless, one doesn't speak of time in all these phase transitions. So, and the question is it the time dependence of physical quantities in thermodynamical equilibrium possible at all or not. So the first person who has started to speak of possibility of existence of quantum time crystal was Frank Wilczek, who proposed that such time crystals could be possible. And his idea was, let us take some superfluid or superconductor and with some inhomogeneity of this in the current, and if this current will flow, superconducting flows without any resistivity, and if you have something, some inhomogeneity of density, then it will somehow oscillate in time. Of course, he was immediately criticized by people who even almost immediately have calculated in the model proposed by Frank Wilczek. They calculated the thermodynamically stable state, and it was homogeneous. The state proposed by Wilczek was not the thermodynamically stable state. And even some time after that, even some kind of no-go theorem was proposed, which showed that thermodynamically stable microscopic states are not possible. However, it was realized that in principle, one can speak about long-living non-equilibrium time crystals. they were loud, and there is a big somehow excitement now. There have been recent experiments published in Nature, and if one clicks in Google, time crystal, quantum time crystal, one can find a lot to read. So now there was another proposal, Sergei Mukhin in Moscow, who proposed that there could be imaginary time periodical structure in imaginary time with period of 1 over t if it is bosonic. And then he studied that, but unfortunately, Hubbard-like model and solution of mean field equation, but unfortunately, the major imaginary time independent solution was always thermodynamically more favorable. So what I want to speak now that in principle, space-time crystal, in spite of that no-go theorem is possible, simply that theorem, I think is not applicable to the present situation. And I want to consider explicitly the model that we developed with my PhD student, Pavel Volkov, for description of underdoped superconducting cuprates. We suggested that it would be good to have this model because it may describe at least phenomenologically, it could be a low energy theory in order to describe many different effects in cuprates. So I will tell what this model is and which may be relevant for cuprates. But again, this model is rather simple and is can be much more general than for application in cuprates. So just let me remind you why I want to have something new for the pseudo-gap state, for example, that one has this this beautiful picture where one sees a lot of different experiments indicating there is boundary for the pseudo-gap state. There is a charge density wave with modulation along the bonds and D form factor. There is superconductivity, and there are a lot of experiments. Also, one can sees time reversal breaking. One has also polarized Kerr effect and even inversion symmetry breaking. So a lot of things happens here. So, and then of course we know that studying different models like Hubbard model or TJ model is already has a long history, but still when one starts speaking of all these effects, it is not so it is usually numerical, one doesn't have big systems and so on. And therefore, it would be good to try something new. I want only to remind that all these experiments show D-wave superconductivity, pseudo-gap states, so this is gap at the antinodes, violation of time reversal and inversion symmetry, then D-form factor charge density wave with the modulation along the bonds, violation of the rotational symmetry is known pneumatic state, and so on. And what is general feature, why we wanted to propose some low energy, model, effective model, that all these transition temperatures, what everything is happens on the temperature range of 100, 300 Kelvin, which is much lower than electronic temperatures. And then, of course, one can start thinking, why not to suggest some model that could be relevant for this region. So, and this model was suggested with Pavel Volkov and me. It was spin fermion model with overlapping hotspots. So spin fermion model has been studied for quite a long time. These are points that can be connected by antiferromagnetic vector, and there are 8 of them. If they start to overlap, but they must start overlapping because this distance is also quite small between these parts of the Fermi surface. And these hotspots start overlapping, and as one can speak of, instead of 8, one can speak of 2 hot regions, just two hot regions. And if one wants to study, to follow this idea, one can propose effective low energy Lagrangian or Hamiltonian, so which contains two parts of the spectrum, one and two. So these two are already equivalent by translations. And these are two bands somehow, two effective bands, epsilon 1 here, epsilon 2 here, electrons, and interaction with them. And this interaction is just antiferromagnetic fluctuations and in usual conventional spin fermion model with some spectrum. But for the further consideration for me, this exact spectrum is not so important. One can just take some constant here. And in matrix notation, is this Lagrangian is H naught. H naught, this contains epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 1 half here, epsilon minus here, and Pauli matrices which correspond to this pseudo spin, these two the regions. And what is important, one has interaction between these two regions, and that's it. Not more complicated. So, and previously with Pavel we studied that, and in principle, depending on the this spectrum, this alpha and beta coefficients, effective masses of this spectrum in both these things, and chemical potential to temperature, we had this problem of spin fermion model with diagonal modulation. This state in this model may convert in just to Pomeranchuk instability with deformation of Fermi surface and nematicity. There is charge density wave, but there is also some state with loop currents, which is more or less, I will tell what is that, and also some incommensurate. So a lot of phases are there, and of course superconductivity. So in that sense, it was quite nice that one can get many things. So and let me, so with this charge density wave, superconductivity, everything is clear. There is also pneumaticity. So let me dwell on one of the solutions of this Fermi model, this new solution. It was formation gap of the antinodes, no charge modulation, but orbital current modulation. So it was just this modulation. It could be obtained in the field approximation, and actually this structure is similar to so-called DDW state with the other parameter, which is in this notation, so just sigma 2, it is imaginary, and therefore it is loop current. The problem to use this solution for cuprates was that it had not been seen in any spin polarized neutron experiments. It has not been seen by any other tools. So although if they existed, they had to be seen. Now, but at the same time, this state is not so bad for cuprates because one has here gaps at the antinodes, doubling the period, and then you have this pocket which corresponds, for example, to this experiment. So it would be good to have something like that, but again, it contradicts to absence of any signal in neutron spin polarized neutron scattering. So now I stop to speak of cuprates and will come to this new state that I want to present now. So which is more or less this DDW state, but oscillating in time. So one can visualize it in this way. So if one considers this model that one can get consider in mean field approximation to identify two different order parameters. This is loop currents with pi pi, and this is corresponds to charge density wave with the period pi pi. The problem is, the point is that this corresponds, these currents correspond to attraction in this channel, but this charge density wave corresponds to repulsion. And if one considers the green function for this system, These are those equations. These are self-consistency equation. And easy solution that can be immediately found is just, so this is electronic part of this action containing this sigma matrices, Pauli matrices of pseudo-spin. And one can immediately write time-independent solution. So putting this charge B1 equal to zero and this current, just looking for the current. And one gets time-independent equations. If one assumes that it is time-independent, one gets this equation and one can just usually how one proceeds in the mean field with mean field solutions, one can find this solution corresponding to this loop currents. So this is if one considers this time independence. Then the question, is that always the ground state? Is that always the lowest energy? Now I will try to present that no, in principle, even lower state in free energy is possible. So those instantons in imaginary time, it is not something transition from some state to another state. It will correspond to the thermodynamically lowest energy. That's the point. So time-independent solutions. One can try for that equation time-independent. First, one can try time-independent. Just taking naively that this charge fluctuations are absent. And one can find the time-independent solution exactly. So you have this equation for the green function, which is quite already complicated. And we have this mean field equation. It turns out that, of course, there is time-independent solution, but there is another exact solution, or the many solutions, which are this gamma some coefficient. And this is snoidal elliptic function, which contains this modulus k, which changes between 0 and 1, and some arbitrary gamma, and this imaginary time tau. And if B1 equals to 0, just considering this exact equation for gamma, one can get this exactly self-consistency equation containing only gamma and k, and some function of kp, but not really, this is just some almost algebraic equation. And if one puts k equals zero, just instead of this, this epsilon cancels this one, and one gets just mean field solution that I have shown previously. But if k is not equal to unity, then one has this elliptic function. So I remind you what this elliptic function is. One can imagine, visualize this function in a very simple way. Suppose one has a potential, x squared minus x to the fourth power. This is this one. Suppose one wants to describe motion of a classical particle moving in this potential. So one can have different possibilities. This classical particle can either oscillate, so, or it can start here with zero velocity, go down, and end here. This is solution. This is exact solution, the simple solution. It is hyperbolic tangent when k goes to zero, goes to one. If k goes to zero, it is just sine. This is just these trivial oscillations. So therefore, this is just what one can calculate if one has k squared, for example, this 0.99, then this function is like this chain of instanton, anti-instanton. This is instanton tangent, hyperbolic tangent x, this instanton, anti-instanton, and one has these chains. And one has the condition, if we consider imaginary time, then we have to have periodicity with 1 over t. So this order parameter B is somehow already boson, and it has to have bosonic boundary conditions. So therefore, it is just this instantons in imaginary time that was present in the previous title of my talk. So this is chain of anti-instanton, anti-instanton. Now, most important properties of the elliptic functions. So double periodicity in complex plane. They are periodic not only along this real axis, they are periodic also along complex axis. So we use this periodicity, this m must be integer, and this k is actually elliptic integral of the first kind. And so now one should do the following thing. I claim that this is thermodynamical state with the lowest energy. This means that I have to try use these solutions, insert it into the action of free energy, and calculate what is more favorable energetically. So these are solutions. This can be done numerically. That's what I did numerically. And so I have chosen these energies like quadratic near these antinodes. This is expansion near antinodes, some constants. And this gamma is gamma that can be determined from the self-consistency equation for the homogeneous solution. Then I have free parameter somehow nematicity. These are different chemical potential at this regions P and 1, and this is some cutoff. So then I calculate the difference between this inhomogeneous state and this homogeneous. So this is homogeneous, action of homogeneous state. This is this solution with m instantons. And this is actually linear in the number of instantons in the main approximation. One can see that if I just insert it, I get this energy as a function of these two coordinates and x and y. And this difference is always positive. So no solution if you just consider this equation, just possibility of these loops. Situation changes. If one takes into account this field B1, which are just charges. And one can, so therefore it cannot give any solution, independent solution. But if one expands in B1 up to linear and quadratic terms, one can integrate out this B1, and this B1 plays a role of a gluon. And this gluon somehow tries to put these currents to this other parameter B together. And if one integrates, one can find this additional term. So delta S naught is always positive, but there is an additional term written in terms of the Green function. What I will do later after that, then if I write also this term, I cannot solve everything exactly, just this equation, self-consistency equation, but I can try variationally to take B in the form of snoidal function and see what happens with the energy. If I can get energy lower than the homogeneous one, I can say, okay, maybe it is not the lowest possible because the exact solution is not a snoidal function, but at the same time, I can prove that this exact solution resembles very much this snoidal function, this hyperbolic tangent, although, okay, I don't want to go into details of these things. I just show pictures. This is total action, so I take this k modulus 0.45, and then I still have only positive values of this action. Then I take larger k, and then I get already negative possibility of negative region, and here also negative. And if I make cuts, these cuts when the action difference of actions is zero here. And these lines correspond somehow to self-consistency equation that should be satisfied. Therefore, if these self-consistency equations, and I take coupling constants 3, 1, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay. So then it looks that I have really the solution, that the energy is lower. Then I calculate in real time. If I know that this function is doubly periodic, I have to integrate it as degenerate with respect to this T naught and tau naught. And then after this averaging, I get oscillating function of time. So this non-decaying oscillations, so one can speak of perfect qubit, but I don't have time to speak of that. And then frequency time, one has the sum of delta functions. And what is important, it is sum over n from unity to infinity. And there is no elastic scattering. That now elastic scattering, delta function at omega equal to zero, doesn't exist. And therefore, there is no static order, and which then, if think, and this would mean a neutron scattering, that I have this function without static order, and with Q equals 20 ferromagnetic Q. So that's the result. And then if K is close to 1, then to gamma is the gap. And if one wants to ask me what does it mean, this oscillation, I give an example of just trivial harmonic oscillation. So average of any operator, for example, odd in a coordinate is zero. So you don't have any average if you calculate the average of some operator. But if you calculate the average of the product of two operators, so evolution in time, then you immediately get these oscillating terms. It is just the transitions from the ground state and to other state. So these oscillations that I get has this origin. So this is also quantum oscillations between zero and excited states. So therefore, my conclusions at the moment are that there is a state that is periodic with all the parameter periodic in imaginary time, and this no-go theorem is not applicable if one has both oscillations in imaginary time and real time, and can be visualized this result as a macroscopic two-level system. This must lead to a completely new type of phase transition. So as the order average quantum mechanical average of this parameter is zero, one shouldn't expect somehow a perpetuum mobile, just perpetual mobile, or how it is in English. So therefore, there is no contradiction with common sense. And maybe it is a new proposal for pseudo-gap state incorporates. It is somehow something like DDW state, which gives a doubling of the period and all these nice things. But it cannot be seen by using elastic scattering. But there should be some peak in inelastic scattering, although it may be weak. So gap at the antinodes, doubling period, and that's the end.